On behalf of Chennai Citizens Forum and New India Forum, I, Dr. M. Ramkumar, the President of Chennai Citizens Forum, is extending a warm welcome to this August gathering on a program on Citizenship Amendment Act 2019 to be delivered by our Honorable, Respectful Finance Minister, Srimati Nirmala Sitharaman. This program is being organized primarily to clear the misinformation campaign and to allay the fears of fellow Indians. Let each one of us who are present here be an ambassador to assure our fellow citizens about the need and benefit of Citizenship Amendment Act 2019. Let me start with a quote from our Honorable, Respectful Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi, the tallest leader of this country and the subcontinent, and we are, in our generation, we are seeing the one of the greatest leaders about this fact. He clearly says, his words are, "This act illustrates India's centuries-old culture of acceptance, that is important, acceptance, harmony, compassion, and brotherhood." What is Citizenship Amendment Act? The Citizenship Amendment Act is for number 47 of 2019, is an amendment to the existing constitutional amendment of Citizenship Act of 1955. This was enacted by the Parliament in the 70th year of Republic of India. This act is as follows. This act will benefit persons belonging to 6 distinct religious minorities, namely in the Hindus, Sikh, Buddhist, Parsis, and the Christian communities who have migrated to India after facing persecution on the grounds of religion in Pakistan, Afghanistan, and Bangladesh. Actually, this is aimed at giving a dignified life to, a way of life to people on humanitarian basis to those people who have suffered severe religious persecution for decades by granting Indian citizenship after fulfilling certain basic conditions. This act does not deprive any Indian citizen of his citizenship. This was a fallacy spread by a lot of people. Nobody will be, no Indian citizen will be deprived of any citizenship. And the Citizenship Amendment Act has nothing to do with the National Resident Charter. Why? The legal provisions of the National Resident Charter have been part of the Citizenship Amendment Act of 1955 and had been in force since December 2004. Further, there is also a cut-off date, which is December 31, 2014. And the benefits under the Act will be available to only those people who have migrated to this country before 2014, December 31, not for those people who have migrated after December 31, 2004 to this country. It does not affect any citizen of any religion, including the religious minority, the Muslim. So there is no question of being against any religious minorities. Every Indian citizen is being protected, and this act is only applicable to the religious minorities who are living in the Indian subcontinent except India. It is applicable only to those people. Everybody is aware that this country at the time of independence was bifurcated on the religious line. But we Indians choose to be secular. That is the magnanimity of the Indians. When other religious minorities, for Hindus, Christians, Sikhs, Parsis, who are settled in Indian subcontinent like Bangladesh, Afghanistan, and Pakistan, when they are faced persecution, it is the duty of our every citizen to protect them and to grant the livelihood and way of giving a citizenship. This is what our constitution also said, even when Jawaharlal Nehru was a prime minister, this was speculated. In fact, in 2014, following the settlement of Indo-Bangladeshi border dispute, about 14,864 Bangladeshi citizens were given Indian citizenship when their enclaves were incorporated into the Indian territory. The majority of them were Muslims. It is the duty of our every citizen of this country to understand this act, not to get misled by vested interests, because the vested interests always try to get create confusion. Whatever the good things is being done by our government, by our leader, Sri Narendra Modi ji. And also, let me conclude this with a quote from, once again, from our Honorable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi ji, who unequivocally assures our fellow citizens that this act does not affect any citizen of India of any religion. This act is only for those who face years of persecution outside the country and no other place to go except India, and it is our bounden duty, and it is also mentioned in the Constitution, to protect our people. So once again, I am thanking our patrons of Chennai Citizen Forum, Mr. Atma Ratma Shankar ji and K.T. Raghavan ji, and the convener of New India Forum, Srimadi Vanadi Srinivasan, for taking this a bold initiative and organizing the much needed program. Our madam, the chief guest, is going to enlighten much more on the intricacies of the Amendment Act. Welcome, madam.